Well, we're already up to 51 degrees here on Melrose Mountain at higher ground, and sun is out. It's a beautiful day. It's gonna get up a little bit warmer, probably mid 50s, and it's just gonna be a beautiful day. So we're enjoying the beautiful day. Mark chapter 6. It's really interesting how many different ways you can apply the Word of God to your needs. For the first section of this scripture, deals with his disciples coming back, having been out on a mission, a test, if you will, from Jesus, without any provisions, trusting in God's supply through humankind. And they come back and they're exhausted. They've been so busy healing people and preaching the word that they haven't even had time to eat. Ever had times like that in your life when things were so busy? Well, we're coming up on the holidays, and lots of times that's exactly what happens. We're so busy racing around to stores and cooking and cleaning and inviting in guests and everything else that we're exhausted and don't even have time to eat. Well, it says that when they reached that point in chapter 6, verse 30, they were harried, they were tired, they were worn out. And Jesus did what all of us should do. He says, "Come on, come with me. I want to give you some rest." That means taking away some time for yourself in solace, that is, in quietness and in slowness. Rest doesn't mean going to Disney World. Rest doesn't mean going on a big fancy fishing trip. Rest means just that, rest. I remember Dr. Henry Brandt used to tell a story about somebody wanting him to come and speak for them. And he said, "Let me check my calendar for the dates that they wanted." And he said, "I've scheduled to do nothing that day." And they said, "That's good. It means you can come." And he says, "No, you don't understand. I've scheduled to do nothing that day." Now, what he meant was he set aside a day to do nothing, to just truly relax and rest. And we need to do that sometimes. Time of rest doesn't mean a time of activity away from our routine. It means truly to rest. And sometimes we just need to do that. The second thing that we see in this section of scripture is the hungry. This is where we find the story of the feeding of the 5,000. We find the barley loaves and the fish, and we see that if we do our part, he'll do his part. He'll take care of the hungry, even with limited provisions. But we got to remember, we got to do our part. We got to bring forth what we have to offer and then trust him for the rest. The third part of this story is the helpless. That is, his disciples were crossing over the Sea of Galilee again. And they were fighting against the wind and the sea, and they were making no gain with rowing on the oars. In the middle of the night, he came walking to them. He got into the boat, and they had forgotten his supply of the feeding of the thousands, and now they had hardened their hearts against the fact that Jesus can help you out of anything, including being stuck out in the middle of the sea. And it's very interesting because we also see as he goes across the shore with his disciples that all kinds of people with physical infirmities came. They too were helpless to get their own cure, but he cured all of those that came to him. And we see his ability. And so we have five things that we need to learn here. First of all, we need to learn that he's aware. He's aware of our troubles and our problems, whether they be harried or hungry or helpless or hurting. He's available. He may not answer in our time frame, but he will answer. And he's not only aware, but he's available. Thirdly, we need to remember that he's aware. He's aware of all of the things going on in our lives. And he is available to us. And he's aware and able to take care of whatever our problem. So we see all of these things that he's aware, available, and able to take care of all of our needs. We need to be sure we don't harden our hearts. We need to be sure we look back on previous times when we've had difficulties and see how he handled those and not harden our hearts thinking that he can't take care of whatever our problems are. As we approach this Thanksgiving season, I think it's important for us to give thanks for the fact that he is available, that he is able, that he is aware of all of the things going on in our lives. We need to give thanks for that, because all we've got to do is do our part, and he'll take care of the rest. That's your thought for the day. God bless you, and have a great day.